Welcome back. We'll start with the next topic for Kurukshetra October 2017 that deals with Swachhta. Now, however, this is a very recent issue. It's very, very important for your upcoming mains examination. So have a good note on it. Many of the points and many of the case studies here could be part of your answers while you are explaining the various concepts. So let's start with a basic idea. We'll start with Swachh Bharat Mission. Now, Swachh Bharat Mission was started in 2014 with a 5-year goal. So the idea was on the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, we will achieve the mission of Swachhta. However, we have further started with more missions, and this is the foundation stone for the further missions where we talk about Swachhta Hi Seva Hai, and we talk about the 2022 targets. Now, the idea was to bring 550 rural households out of the open defecation. Till now, 5 states have been declared open defecation free. Those are Sikkim, Haryana, Uttarakhand, Kerala and Himachal Pradesh. Many of the villages, nearly all of the villages along the Ganga River have been declared open defecation free. 5 crore toilets have been built and the sanitation cover has increased from nearly 39% to 69%, which is really remarkable. However, the main idea is to bring about a change in the behavior of the individuals. So behavioral change is the key aspect where we lag behind. And changing the individual's habit is another thing that we need to focus on. So again, many of the villages were declared ODF, that's open defecation free. However, there was slip back in many of the villages. As a result, there has been a kind of evaluation that has been going on, and based on that we are assessing the recent status. Now a further effort has been done in this, which is the open defecation free plus the SLRM, that's the solid liquid resource management, together they would give you ODF plus status. So now what we aim to achieve is the ODF plus status rather than the ODF status, and we are moving from the output to outcome. So it's not only building the number of infrastructure or building the infrastructure, we are looking forward for an outcome where there has been a recent change or a real change in the sanitation habits. So that is the basic idea. Now many of the things have been going through the virtual classrooms where you have a central trainer who interacts at multiple locations and trains people. The Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen talks about a 90-day window for third party verification once a village declares itself open defecation free. There has been the concept of Swachhta Rath in Allahabad with the help of Nukkad Natak. There have been 2 villages, this is very, very important and can be part of your case study in your various answers. These 2 villages, the Virpur Khurd in Dehradun and Mala in Pauri Garhwal, have been taken up by Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation, and they have been declared as Model Ganga villages in collaboration with Global Interfaith Wash Alliance, that is known as GIWA. So that's a very, very important case study. We'll be talking about this more in map location class, that's again very important. Now talking about the economics of investing in Swachhta. Now, the open defecation has led to problems of diarrhea, child mortality, and the problems and the issues of dignity. Now, we have nearly 1 lakh preventable deaths that could be managed by creating a proper sanitation facility. 40% of the children are physically and cognitively stunted, and the reason behind that is again due to lack of sanitation. A budget of $20 million for 5 years has been given, and now this has been given to various private sector and faith institutions. The highest contribution has come from Mata Amritanandamayi with 100 crore donation, and that's a kind of highest contribution for Swachh Bharat Mission Abhiyan. Various ministers, ministries and departments of the government have been working, and so far 12,000 crore has been kept as a budget for 2017-18. Now Prime Minister is offering Shramdan for the construction of twin pit toilets, and we'll be talking about more about this in the next section of the class. And this was an effort in Sarshanpur
village in Varanasi, and this has been named as Izzat Ghar. So that's again very, very important. So some of the terms are directly very important. Now October is important because this month you have numerous birth anniversaries. On 2nd October you have the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi and Lal Bahadur Shastri. 11th October is the birth anniversary of Jai Prakash Narayan and Nanaji Deshmukh, and 25th September was the birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. So all these are very, very important, and because of that October has been considered as a month to achieve cleanliness and to give a drive for cleanliness. Now when we talk about clean India, we start with Swachhta Darpan. Now Swachhta Darpan is a district ranking on the performance and the sustainability, and looks after the transparency, and this is again very important. Based on that, this village Swachhta index has been given, where nearly 1.5 lakh villages have been part of it. We already talked about the ODF plus status. Now Jilla Swachhta Swachh Bharat Preraks are the youths who are involved in the effort of Swachhta and cleanliness. Then you have Swachh Bharat Hackathon. Now this is very, very important, which was known as Swachhathon 1.0. We'll be talking about that more in detail. Now this was innovative ideas to be incorporated for Swachhta. So it includes zero emission incinerators, then you have plastic substitutes for low cost urinals and so on. So all those are new suggestions that have come up for cleanliness, and those are really innovative solutions which should be part of the Swachh Bharat Mission. Now Swachh Sankalp Se Swachh Siddhi, this was the government efforts, and you have numerous film competition, essay competition and painting competition that were organized on behalf of this. So you have the Darwaja Band initiative by Amitabh Bachchan. Now Swachhta Hi Seva campaign, why it is important? So there are few things that have been part of it. First is construction of toilets, then you have cleaning of parks, ponds, hospitals and public places, building public and community toilets, changing the behavioral habits and promoting gender sensitive information under the gender guidelines 2017. Then you have the various role of celebrities. Besides that, you have the Anganwadi project, the corporate partnership and so on. Now you have the twin pit flush water seal toilet. That's very, very important. Now this is to avoid any kind of underground pollution in low-lying areas. This was incorporated for 3 years, and the idea is there would be twin pits, and once one is filled, the next would be used, and both of those would have a honeycomb structure where the watery part would be filtrated and the remaining would be there for 2-3 years until it becomes odorless, and then it could be used as a manure. So this is a new effort. However, in the coastal areas you have different alternates, which mainly include the Ecosan and the bio toilets. Then we already talked about Swachhathon 1.0, where you have the ideas, the innovative ideas, then changing the behavioral habits, better solutions and better technology that could be brought up. Now there are various innovations that have been brought up, where you have bamboos that are used instead of bricks, then you have other incinerators and other efforts. The world record has been set up for the biggest toilet in the world, which is Pandharpur in Pune border. Now this was given by the Sulabh International Director, that is B. Pathak, and he talked about this would be the largest, much more bigger than China. Now we are coming forward with a new concept which talks about waste to wealth. Now under this idea, we are talking about the sources of renewable energy. We talk about wind energy, which contributes to 56% of the renewable energy. However, we are moving on with the waste generation from the waste, and this contributes to nearly 0.2%, and we plan to increase this contribution further. Now if we classify the types of waste, there are 4 basic types of waste: the industrial waste, urban waste, biomass and biomedical waste. Under the urban waste, we talk about sludge, fecal matter and municipal solid waste. Under the industrial waste, we talk about hazardous and non-hazardous. Now hazardous, in India you have nearly 8 million ton of hazardous waste per year, of which Maharashtra and Gujarat are the highest contributors, and 7 states, the top 7 states form 82% of the hazardous waste contribution, and we need to seriously control the hazardous waste, which is a real problem. As we said, waste to power contributes to only 0.2%. We need to increase this ratio, and once this is increased, this could be a kind of innovative approach for power generation. So we are using this under four heads. First is the thermal conversion, which involves high temperature. Then you have thermochemical conversion, which involves high temperature and decomposition, including pyrolysis and gasification. Biochemical conservation, which includes enzyme reactions, and electrochemical electrochemical conversion, which talks about oxidation reduction. So this is the idea, and of now we have nearly a total of 1460 megawatts of solid waste and a potential from sewerage, which is around 225 megawatts, of which we are actually using or exploiting only 24 megawatts. That means we are using less than 1.5% of what actually could be used, and therefore we have a lot way to go ahead and use the waste to energy, which is a kind of new concept that is coming up. Now the next is National Mission for Clean Ganga. We already talked about the five states through which the Ganga goes. So you have Uttarakhand, Bihar, UP, Jharkhand and West Bengal. It covers an area of 8.6 lakh square kilometers with nearly 46% population, 118 towns and 1657 gram panchayats. Now some of the ideas include a kind of GIS platform for monitoring. You have effluent management system, sanitation coverage, model dhobi ghats that could be created, maintaining the flow without changing the natural season variation, maintaining the water quality, conserving the aquatic biodiversity, and making Ganga floodplains as construction free zones. So these are some of the initiatives done under the National Mission for Clean Ganga. Very, very important, and many of your answers could be substantiated with National Mission on Clean Ganga. Now Gandhiji and sanitation. Gandhiji said that everyone must be his own scavenger. So it's not required to have a kind of sanitation issues or sanitation problems in the country if everyone looks after their own waste. Under the Sustainable Development Goal 6, we talk about availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. And with this motto, we move forward and we talk about Gandhi's experiment on building and cleaning the toilets, emancipating the sanitation workers, and removing any kind of social discrimination, along with the issues of untouchability, which Gandhiji laid forward. Now his concern started with South Africa, where he was exposed to the English settlements, and they explained how the sanitation is important, and villages were actually the virtual hills. So we need to work around the sanitation issues more in the villages. Gopal Krishna Gokhale was the political guru of Gandhiji, and he explained Gandhiji that every time you are looking to work around any issue, you should devote at least 1 year researching on it. So based on that, he researched for years and finally led to a solution that sanitation is one of the major issues in the villages, and that was prior to his death. And again in Navjeevan and Young India, he frequently wrote about the issues of sanitation. There are various social innovations that have been taking place. Sanitation and Environment Institute in Sugar, Gandhinagar is one of those. Along with that, you have Sulabh International in India. 2016 Magsaysay Award winner was Bayswada Wilson, and he did a remarkable work for the manual scavenging. Still, there are 2 lakh manual scavengers that exist in India. Now, biogas promotion is again a very big issue. Gujarat Vidyapeeth is working forward to it, and it's asking more and more universities to come and collaborate to this issue. Biogas plants have been built along the various highways and the highway dhabas. So that's again an important initiative. Some of the important excerpts were the Saubhagya scheme that talks about Prime Minister Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. Now what was the issue here was the electricity was coming to the villages. You have the pole in front of your house, but still the electricity is not in the house and the houses are in darkness. So how to avail that electricity was a basic issue, and for that you have the Saubhagya scheme that has been started to provide electricity connection to 4 crore poor people and provide power or electricity to all homes. The next is Swachh Bharat Kosh, started in 2014. It was, the idea was to channelize the corporate social responsibility of the funds repair the various community toilets and improve the sanitation facilities. Now, there have been 3 case studies. Now, these case studies could be part of your answer writing whenever there is a question on Swachhta or Swachh Bharat Mission. So, these case studies basically talk about individual efforts on how to create a kind of betterment in the society. One was the example of Bilal Dhar. He was from Srinagar, who was cleaning the Wooler Lake and has been made as one of the brand ambassadors in that area. Then you have the Narsingpur district in Madhya Pradesh, where which is basically a region of sugar mill, and you have 2 major highways that cross it, and you have the Narmada river that flows nearby. The idea was the local people there were putting up slogans in front of their house and they were creating awareness. People were moving with whistles, and anyone who is found to violate the laws was punished or was asked to refrain those. So those were some of the efforts here. Then you have Mondita Chatterjee's example from Jamshedpur, where she talked about building the plant toilets. And that is the reason where you have the dropouts that could be reduced in the schools. So these were some of the efforts that have been done by the government. A very, very important addition, important for your upcoming exam as well. And we'll be covering more lectures of Kurukshetra and Yojana in the upcoming classes. So stay tuned. If you have any doubts or comments, you can leave those in the comment section below the video. Have a very good day ahead.